no prep, you poop, you scoop a little on the vial, and you're done. Think a colonoscopy is the only way to be screened for colorectal cancer? Well, good news! In today's video, I'm going to be talking about four different screening options that are available to you. Yes, there's more than just a colonoscopy available if you're of average risk and aren't experiencing any symptoms. As a colorectal cancer survivor myself, I've learned about all of these options, and I've even attended a workshop talking about all of them. Before I get into these options, let me introduce myself to you. My name is Jelena, and I was diagnosed with stage 3 rectal cancer in 2016 at the age of 34. I created this channel, Life as a Cancer Survivor, to talk about the ins and outs of colorectal cancer and what it's like to go through treatment for it. First up, the colonoscopy. This is the gold standard for screening in the United States, and 90% of screening is done via a colonoscopy. In case you're unfamiliar with what a colonoscopy is, it is where they examine your large intestine, also known as your colon, using a very small camera that is at the end of a flexible tube, and it's inserted into your body through your anus. The good thing about a colonoscopy is if nothing is found during it, then you don't need your next one for another 10 years, which means you may only need to do 4 in your entire lifetime. Another pro is that if small polyps are found, they can be removed during the procedure. A polyp, it's a small growth in your large intestine, and it can grow and turn into cancer if left there. Usually, polyps grow very slowly, which is why you only need a colonoscopy once every 10 years. There are, of course, cons to colonoscopies, and I bet you can name the first one without my help. Yes, it's the bowel prep. I don't know of anyone that enjoys purging their bowels, but it's a necessary step so that the doctor can get a clear view of the walls of your entire colon. I've done multiple different types of preps, so if you'd like for me to do a video on what each of those are like, let me know in the comments below. Other cons to the procedure are that you do need to be sedated for it, which means that someone is going to need to accompany you to the procedure to take you home after. One final con is that there's a very small chance that your bowel could become perforated during the procedure. But that chance is 0.0004%, so a very small percent. Option number 2 is Hemoccult or gFOBT test, which stands for guaiac fecal occult blood test. This is the first of the at-home options and was the first one that became available, but it's not used much at all anymore, and you'll understand why as I explain the test a bit here. First, to prepare for the test, 3 days before, you have to avoid eating red meat, raw fruits and vegetables, vitamin C and fruit juices that can contain vitamin C and acids. You have to stop taking medications to stop diarrhea, iron supplements, and non-steroid anti-inflammatory drugs, also known as NSAIDs. And you can't take any vitamin E. So then after those 3 days, then you collect 3 different stool samples over a period of another 3 days. Pros to this test are you don't have to do a bowel prep and you don't have to be sedated. The con is that you still have to adjust your diet for 3 days prior to the test, and then that test lasts for 3 days. You've got to take 3 stool samples, 1 on each of those days. Option number 3 is the FIT, which stands for fecal immunochemical test. And this one has largely replaced the Hemoccult test. Why? Well, diet doesn't affect this test at all, so there's zero prep required. Let me show you what the kit looks like and how exactly it works. So it all comes in this small envelope. It's not too complicated. Inside here, you get tissue paper, the vial to put the sample in, an absorbent pad, a Ziploc baggie to put the sample in, and then you get the envelope to return it back to the lab in. So, how you do it? You get ready by, feeling that you gotta go to the bathroom. You use the tissue paper to lay on the water in the toilet bowl. My husband took this test and he actually thought it was easier to lay the tissue paper like underneath the seat to catch the stool before it hits the water. Up to you. You just need to deposit your stool sample on this tissue paper. Then once the sample is on there, you use the little vial, you take the cap off, and there's this little probe. You swipe that around in the stool sample, and you stick it in here. You wrap this up with the absorbent pad, and you stick it in the biohazard. Seal it, and then you put it in the envelope and tear off the thing. And they'll give you instructions. Ours, it says, please do not mail. We were supposed to take it back to our doctor's office where they've got, like, the lab where they would draw your blood and stuff. You'd drop it off there. And that's it. No prep. You poop. You scoop a little on the vial. And you're done. Pros to this test is it's pretty easy to do and you can do it at home. The cons are it's not as sensitive as a colonoscopy, so you have to do this test every year. Your last option, or option number four, is the Cologuard test. What's the difference between FIT and the Cologuard test? Well, the Cologuard is actually two tests in one. It's a FIT and a DNA test. So Cologuard ships you a bit of a fancier setup for collecting the sample. You get a plastic insert that goes between your seat and the bowl of the toilet. You get a bucket that fits in that insert and you plop your sample into that bucket. Like the FIT test, you have a little probe that you need to get some stool on and stick into a tube. But then you also will just add some liquid to that bucket, seal it up, and send the bucket itself back to Cologuard as well. The DNA part of the test is looking for DNA mutations in genes related to colorectal cancer, but it doesn't test every single gene. Cologuard does offer follow-up support if it is shown that you have a genetic mutation so that you're not completely left in the dark as to what exactly that means. Pros to this test are very similar to the FIT. It can be done at home, there's no prep required, and it's pretty easy to do. Cologuard even has videos on their website that walks you through how exactly to do the test. This test is more sensitive than the FIT test, so you only need to take this one every 3 years. Cons to this test are, since it is more sensitive, there is a little bit of a higher chance that you may get a false positive, which would just mean you would end up getting referred to a colonoscopy so that they could see exactly what's going on inside of your colon. Now that you know a little bit more about the four different screening options for colorectal cancer, I want to remind you that the screening age has recently been lowered to 45. So if you're 45 or older and you have not been screened yet, call your doctor today to schedule that appointment. It could save your life. If you want to hear a little bit more about what it's like to get a colonoscopy, you can click on the video over here to watch the vlog that I did on my most recent colonoscopy. Want to find out more about what the symptoms are of colorectal cancer? Click on the video right down here. And make sure that you're subscribed so you don't miss any of my future videos. Thanks for watching.